City Transit is in search of a new leader.
Yeah, today marks the end of the line for the woman who was handed the reins a year and a half ago and guided us through one of the scariest times in the city's history. Interim President, Transit President Sarah Feinberg stepping down, stopped by right here on her last day. So good to see you in person.
Yes.
Here in studio one final time, at least as Interim President of New York City Transit. So good to see you here.
Yeah, good to see you.
So this was supposed to be a temporary job. I remember sitting in it right before the pandemic, you came in and then the pandemic happened and then crime happened, right? And this is where we are today. What have you, looking back on the past year, really accomplished and most proud of?
Right. I think I remember coming in here for an interview on like my first day,
yeah.
and we talked about 3 to 6 months. And so 18 months later, here we are.
Yeah.
look, I think in terms of accomplishments, the greatest accomplishment that I look at is just getting us through the darkest days of COVID. And I didn't do that. The men and women of New York City Transit did. So I always say that they carried the city on their backs for, you know, a year and a half. And so I think it's not what any of us wanted to spend the last year and a half on, you all included, but that's what the last year and a half was about. Look, we got other things done. You know, I think we made a lot of progress on buses. We, you know, made a lot of progress on installing CBTC. You know, we addressed the crime issue in a really positive way, I think. But generally, when I look back, it's COVID.
And there's still a lot to look forward to because we're still waiting on this to get passed, and then you be in this new role if that comes to pass. But I want to ask you about the reason of stepping down, because this has been on the books for a little while. This is not, you know, something out of the blue.
Right.
Is it to be with your family?
It is. I mean, look, the president of New York City Transit, that job is a 24/7 job. As I say, you know, you own every rush hour, you own every signal delay, you own every project, you own every incident in the system, every crime, everything. And, you know, this morning I was trying to figure out why we had big headways on the queue. It's never ending. Mm-hmm. And New Yorkers deserve someone who can focus on it 24/7. But after 18 months, it's time for me to spend some time with my family. Mm-hmm. I have a 3.5-year-old at home. I know
I
you
understand.
Have little ones. And it's time to spend a little bit of time with her. So it's a hard thing to talk about because I want women and moms to take these jobs. It's really important that we have more women and moms in transportation, in transit, in public service, in city service, in state service. But I've been doing this for a long time, and it's time to go back to some other parts
Find
of my life.
Find that balance for
your
life.
Yeah,
well, you wait,
no
because it's not like there's nothing on the other side of this.
Exactly, exactly.
And, well, let's talk about the other side, right? Because there's this whole idea of splitting up the CEO of the MTA and making the CEO one job, the board chair another job,
yeah.
right? And there was talks of you taking on one, General Lieber taking on the other. It seems like the Senate's kind of dragging their feet on this very issue. You're talking about dedicating more time to your family. Do you still want that?
I do. Look, the president of transit is 24/7. The board chair position is big picture. It's steering the board. It's steering the agencies. It's big policy decisions about the future of the agency. It's how we get through congestion pricing, fair policy, all of those big issues. What is really tough about the president of transit job is the 24/7 aspect of it. And again, you need someone who can do it 24/7, who can be at those, you know, that incident site at 4 o'clock in the morning, who is on top of, you know, what happened at 12 o'clock, at 11 o'clock at night. So it's just a very different role. To your point on splitting the roles, I still believe it makes sense. Every other transit agency in the country does it this way. Every other transit agency in New York, every major transit agency in the world. Why are we not doing? Do we really think that one person should have sole responsibility for 72,000 employees and multi-billion dollar agency? I just think it makes sense to have more senior, accomplished, experienced folks.
So what's the hold of that?
What, yeah, I was going to say, yeah, if it makes sense, and we've seen it everywhere else, and the governor has nominated you to this, why are we still waiting over a month now?
Almost 2 months.
Yeah.
It's a great question for the New York State Senate. And look, I think, you know, we, Jano and I both have offered, you know, public hearings, briefings, conversations on the record, off the record, public setting, private setting, whatever we can do to help this Senate sort of see through this and get to the other side. And I think the reality is they went out of session and they're focused on other things right now. And I remain hopeful that they'll come back and take this up. But, you know, we remain completely available to answer any questions, to provide briefings. This is just about what makes sense operationally and managerially for the largest agency.
But wouldn't you think the MTA is a priority?
I think, look, it has to be a priority. It's about the future of the city, the future of the state. It's whether the city can recover from the pandemic. And so I think it's really important now more than ever to have strong leadership.
You know, people are going to rumble and rumor about why you're actually stepping down. I saw one of your tweets yesterday about some reporting behind the scenes that just simply said that you didn't want to work too hard.
Oh my God.
And I saw your response to that. There's a lot of rumors that are out there, right? That there may be, that there was not a lot of communication between the mayor and the governor, and that this has been a hard agency to really run if you look at the past years prior to with Andy Byford. Rumor mill?
Yes, absurd. So first of all, yes, it is a big agency and it is hard to run. It's unwieldy and it's hard to steer that ship, which is why we need more people who are experienced and senior who can do it. You know, the comment yesterday was outrageous. And the reason it was outrageous, it's not about me. I know that I work real. So the comment we're talking about was someone suggesting I didn't want to work hard.
Yes.
And that's why I wanted to move to the chair role. So first of all, you know, it's not about me. Anyone who knows me knows that I work extremely hard. But think about if you are a young woman considering entering public service, considering entering the transportation sector, was extremely male-dominated, and you see that on Twitter, you're not interested, right? And that is so frustrating to me. We are trying so hard to get women and moms and girls into these kind of spaces. And when you see that on Twitter, you're just like, you know, is it worth it for me to expose myself like that? Meanwhile, by the way, when we talk about the job being split, Jana would be the CEO, I would be the chair. No one seems to be asking Jana if he doesn't want to work hard, right? So two sides of the same coin, but what someone's treated differently. So anyway, you get used to it at some point.
Well, we thank you for coming in on your last day here and spending a little time with us. And I, you know, personally as a woman, I thank you for the job that you've done for the past 17 years in a business, in a field that is male-dominated.
Yep. Thank you.
And
thank
for
you.
Always being available to us. You've been very good to explain things. Anybody you'd like to see take over New York City Transit?
You know, there are, I will tell you this, there is a great list, and there are really experienced, strong professionals on that list, and I can't wait to see who it's going to be.
All right, Sarah Feinberg, good to see you.
It's very diplomatic of you, Sarah.
Yes. Good to have you here. Thank you for coming in.
Thank you. Good to be with you.